Communication is one of the biggest problems that we are facing. We lack this communication. We don't talk to one another properly. We don't. So what happens is, look at you. You know, I give you one example. Husband and wife were not talking because they had a problem. So no speech. Husband says, not talking to you. So wife tries. She says, please forgive me. You know, I was weak. What I did was wrong. Not talking to you. Okay. Now what happened is, it lasted for about 2 days. And after that, the man had a very, very important appointment. He had a flight to catch at 6 o'clock in the morning. So he leaves a note on the bed of his wife saying, I have a very important meeting. Can you please get me up at 5 o'clock? The note was on the pillow. So when she came to bed, there's no speech between them. So she looks at the note, nods her head. She put the note away. Anyway, the man got up at 10 o'clock in the morning. The sun is out, everything happened. What happened? My wife did not wake me up and she's gone to work already. He was so angry and upset, but there was no speech between them. Anyway, he ran downstairs quickly into the kitchen and put his tea, the water to boil, and he notices a note on the table saying, darling, it's 5 o'clock. Note on the table, meaning I was here waiting for you. There was no speech, I wrote it down. You wrote it for me, I wrote it for you. Okay, this obviously is a joke, but the truth is, the lesson we learn from it is, lack of communication causes big, big issues. Issues that are bigger than the issue we stop talking for. You know that? Why did you stop talking to each other? Why do you have a problem? Sort it out. Speak to each other. Be realistic. You will solve your matter. If you are unrealistic, you know, I know of people who get married and the man thinks, I'm going to change her overnight. Brother, you won't change her besides only her clothing. And that too, maybe she might not want to change. May Allah safeguard us. You won't change anything. She will change on her own. But you need to understand who she is. She's a human being. She also has an upbringing. She has people whom she loves. She has perhaps brothers and sisters or a family, parents and so on. She has an upbringing. She has Allah and a link with Allah that might be different from yours in terms of strength or weakness. But you need to understand, she's not going to change overnight for you. No. And even the other way around, sometimes people get married and they think, a woman thinks, don't worry, this guy, I'm going to change him just like this. You know, I'll change him. Just like that. You don't change a man just like that. It doesn't happen. You need to be realistic. They have an upbringing, so much that they've come with, that's engraved. You will need to slowly and surely work with love and care and understand that the change will come after some years, if it is going to come. And if you're lucky, you might have a sooner than that change, if you're fortunate. But let's get rid of this attitude that I'm going to change. This is why, going back to why do you get married? Go back to Khadija radiallahu anha, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Take a look at how and why he married. He married a woman because he knew her credentials were really very high. The fact that she was 15 years older than him did not bother him, because he said, she will be a good mother to my children and a brilliant wife to me. And guess what? The day he came with revelation, the first person he rushed to was her. And you know, he said, Zammiluni, Zammiluni, you know, cover me, I need a tight hug. And he got that hug from his wife. And she took a keen interest in what he was saying. And she trusted him so much that as soon as he said, this is what happened to me, she believed it. I bear witness, it's true. Today you tell your wife, if she waits for you, I hope it's not with a stick, but if she waits for you, where were you? It's finished, it's over. No matter what you say, you're dead meat. You're dead, meaning she's not going to believe. Just where you were, she doesn't believe. She phones you and says, where are you? You say, oh, I'm sitting in the masjid, but I've got GPS tracking on you. You're sitting in the club. Oh, GPS tracking. No, it's not working. I changed phones. I swapped phones, you know, with a friend of mine. All these lies will get you nowhere. You are a person whom your spouse does not need to phone you to ask you where you are. You should be such, you phone her or you message her or vice versa. Darling, this is where I am. I hope to be home at this time. And if you don't hear from me by that time, please be worried. Wow. Beautiful. What a nice relationship. But the problem is, we don't use these words. We'll use the word darling with a woman we don't really have as a darling. We use the words, I love you, with those whom we're not supposed to be saying them to. So how can we have this marital bliss? We need to be focused, dedicated. You now need to have children and prepare for the next generation and prepare for you to leave the world like everybody else has done. And don't think for a moment that what I've just said is bad. You need to prepare to leave the world because everybody else has gone. We are also going to go. So it's about time I slowed down. I had whatever fun I perhaps might have had a long time ago. I hope inshallah as we grow up also it is clean. You know, you have fun that is clean. But there comes time, a time when responsibility should overtake you in a way that you realize now your role has changed slightly. You cannot keep on going out with the same set of friends that you had before you were married, even after you were married. Otherwise, why did you get married? What was the point? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his life changed completely. And when Nubuwa and prophethood came to him, his wife supported him so much that she took him to Waraqa bin Nawfal, an expert in religious studies, and said, look what happened to this husband of mine. And when he heard the story, he said, you know what? The same angel that came to Jesus has come to you. And soon you will be asked to convey the message. And I hope and I pray that I will be alive the time you are asked to convey the message, so that I can follow you and believe. So now you have this beautiful example of Muhammad, may peace be upon him. He did not treat his wives in a silly way where he abused them. As some people think, oh, in Islam, you know, you just abuse a wife. It is to do with us. We've given the wrong perception because the way we treat our spouses sometimes is really unfit for a Muslim. We think, you know what, I'm the boss, finished. Whatever I say, khalas, that's it. So now she says, I need to read my Salatul Isha. No, we're going to the mall. Is that true? I don't think it happens here in Singapore, does it? I don't think so. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala safeguard us. May He help us, really.